In our wildlife documentary, what are we gonna call it? Nature's Features?
Yeah.
Nature's Private Parts.
Day in the life.
A day in the life.
A day in the life.
All right, guys.
Thing in nature.
So our documentary, in our new documentary, A Day in the Life, features us going out in the wild, and you know, just seeing what it's like, that sort of stuff. So I hope you enjoy it. But I'm Dillon Anderson. This.
I'm Josh and Njobe.
Jacob Salas.
Yeah. And this is our documentary.
This is what I leave school to do some productive shit, shoot a nature video.
Yeah.
Thanks. Like about nature? You know what? Nature's like really homey, you know, like. Like when you walk out there, you instantly want to take off all your clothes because you just feel like you need to be in the grass, being a part of whatever. Like the world is moving, you just need to grip
Agreed.
The world
Agreed.
And just move with it.
Embrace it.
Yeah. Yeah, like if the grass is flowing,
yeah, when you're
you
like,
kind of want to move with the grass.
Like when you caught that turtle, like you didn't have your pants on for most of the movie.
Right.
Which I find that really unique because, you know, there's not a lot of people who are into nature, but rather go into nature half naked. Why do we go into nature? You know, when you're in nature, you have like that presence of freedom. Like you're like, you know how you're like out there? You're like, if you're in outer space, yeah, there's no one there, but you're in your own little world.
Like your cat.
Yeah, this cat. Dude, imagine if we were like, in like the, not Vietnam, but like Native Americans. We had to walk through this stuff every single day. Look, if I was in space, I'd expect to see cats.
Literally, the reason why we went out there was, I went out there because I wanted to find myself.
Let's go up there.
I was actually going to get into the water.
Yeah.
That would be a cool shot. You just...
I think I did find myself.
Did you?
Literally, I know where I'm going to put my soul when I'm reincarnated.
What?
But if there's like snakes in there or
Dude,
something.
That's water's not moving, so that means it has a whole bunch of like contaminants and diseases and stuff.
The water's not moving because it's a f***ing puddle.
You know, it shows what the nature's like is you expect things, but they're not like how you expected. It's a totally different environment, which is really interesting because, you know, in society, you can expect a lot of stuff to happen.
But
you know,
nature.
As far as economy goes and politics, you expect stuff to happen. But nature, anything can happen. A freaking tornado comes, wipes out the whole land, man. Like, extinct, animals go extinct in Ice Age.
Nature.
And, yeah, just anything can happen.
Then we just found a dead animal. We gotta keep going.
We gotta keep going.
I just know if I mess up those shoes, my mom's gonna kill me. Okay, if I could go anywhere in nature, I would want to live in the water.
I mean, like what you're about to do.
Oh, shit, that drop is, whoa, that's a... a pretty far drop, man. I want to be one of those animals that adapted to live in the water. Let me lead up to that. I would want to be in the water, and then I want to come out of the water sometimes, but if I need the water, I can go back.
Like a mermaid?
Like a flipping mermaid.
Well, we're about to go do some more adventuring, so, because that right there would be foolish. I'm fine.
Man. We actually found, okay, we were looking for an El Chupacabra, and we actually
which
found-
Which are true. Which I have seen some in Mexico
which are real.
Times.
And what happened was we were on our search and we actually found poop. All right, are you zoomed in on the poop?
Yeah.
All right, look at where the poop is located, okay? It's like right next to the water. No guy's gonna bring his dog down here and let his dog walk all that close to the water just take a poop. That is an animal that knows what it's doing, which means that we're over here with like flipping coyotes and stuff and like it's-
Wolves.
Wolves, man. That's probably bear poop.
Alright, well, we found poop of it, a chupacabra.
And then we found a dead bird that it had eaten.
Dude, as we see here, this bird was somehow killed and dragged up all the way up in between this tree.
I'm kind of scared of this cone.
There could be an anaconda in there, but we do not know.
There are so many good reasons for us not to be doing this.
How do we survive?
What do you do to survive?
We listen to each other. We take in.
We talk to each other.
Except when Josh stepped in that really dirty water.
Okay.
There was
a point.
I told him not to step in.
There was a point where there was really dirty water, and I stepped.
Yeah, he said it would be okay.
I just walked in it.
And there was mosquitoes everywhere, and
I hated
it.
Doesn't matter. I was walking along.
Mosquitoes are a part of nature.
I tried.
Yeah, but that's not a. I mean, it's nature, but it's not like a good part.
It's nature's parasite.
I just don't understand what you mean by the water looks really bad. Like,
you see how dark it is?
The water's not supposed to be like that. This is the type of water mosquitoes grow in.
I know, man, but what does that mean to me? I'm still gonna walk in it.
That's true.
Connected together by some sort of, because nature is everything when you think about
and
it.
And all we're trying to do is connect ourselves to nature.
Yeah.
But nature was here before me, Dillon and Jacob were. We're just trying to connect ourselves.
I heard people connect themselves to nature through yoga. Do you do yoga? Have you ever done yoga? Have you thought about doing yoga?
Yeah, well, I've heard other people connect to nature by doing drugs, but are they? All right, well, I hope you enjoyed the documentary. And
I'm Jacob. This is Josh. And that's still.
Thank you for watching.
This is a day in the life of a nature documentary with a turtle.
I need a drum. It's like a drum, man. Bye.